Welcome in. It's Hump Day on the Fun Astrology Podcast. Thomas Miller with you on December 11th, Wednesday. Good morning, good day, whatever time you're catching this. We have a lot to do, so let's just jump right on into this. First of all, this is the last full moon of 2019, which makes it the last full moon of the 201.x decade, doesn't it? Yes, so this is it, and it will happen on... Don't you love the universe? Especially if you're in the Eastern time zone. It will happen at 12:12 a.m. on 12:12. And you know, I got a great email from a listener in Australia wondering, how does this work for people in Australia? Well, it certainly works. In fact, if you look at a chart and you just you put Sydney or Melbourne and then look at the configurations for a given time. In fact, you could use this opposition of the sun-moon, which creates the full moon, which is happening at about 19 degrees, 51 minutes. That's U.S. I didn't calculate exactly the minutes for Australia, but it happens at 12:12 Eastern time. And if you calculate that, it's exactly at 4:12 Sydney time. So, yes, obviously, and the moon is, of course, full in the southern hemisphere. So, yes, it absolutely works, even though astrology did originate. I mean, we're talking Babylon, Egypt, and then we're talking the Hellenistic period in Greece and Rome and etc. It still works. It works everywhere. You just sometimes have to make a few little modifications, like changing summer characteristics to winter characteristics on signs and planets and whatnot, but it all works, and there's plenty of stuff online that can help with that as well. Okay, let's talk about this configuration of what's going on right now. First of all, right here this morning, just business at hand, 5:04 a.m., so about the time that this podcast is being released, Venus conjuncts Saturn. Okay, hold everything right there. Did I say Venus? Did I say Saturn? Do you see a problem? Yeah, and that is. And in fact, when this Gemini moon goes full, it will be sandwiched right in between Saturn and Venus. And then just elbow length away, closing the parentheses bracket, if you will, in Capricorn, is Pluto. So what have we been talking about all year? Saturn-Pluto conjunction happening on January 12, 2020, right? We are setting the stage. Like I said yesterday, this is the awe of an historic chart that has not been seen by human eyes in real time since the early 1500s. I mean, that is truly ominous indeed. So what do we have? When we put all of this together, the energy that is overhead right now is kind of spotlight Capricorn, spotlight Gemini full moon. Full moons trigger things. So what are we talking about? Love, relationships, Venus. We're talking about your heart, your soul. Could be relationships. In fact, if you're in a relationship, this would not be a bad time to sit down and plan 2020. Do it under the energy of this full moon. Use that to create together. What about Saturn, Thomas? You said Venus was conjunct Saturn. Yes, that's right. And if you are dealing with relationship issues, could they be magnified? Yes. But let's remember, the moon is in the sign of communication. It's in the sign of the intellect. It's in Gemini. So if you are, again, in a relationship and things are tense, let's bring Saturn into the picture, then you could sit down and draw some ground rules. That's a very Saturnian thing to do. Set up some communication paradigms and say, let's just play here together. Let's use this full moon to see if we can put all of our challenges and differences and issues on the table in a very straightforward Saturnian Capricorn matter-of-fact way. Take the emotion off the table and see if we can work through these things under the beams of the full moon. Now see, to me, that's turning the energy around to use it in one way or another. Oh no, the sky is falling. I'm going to lose my relationship because Venus is conjunct Saturn and it's a full moon. Or You could do what I just said. You can sit down and say, this would be a great time for us to just lay some stuff out. Let's look at our relationship. Let's be aware. Let's honor the energy that's with us, and let's work things out. Now, what if you're single? What if you're not in a relationship? Well, there's always money. Venus rules the bucks. So same thing. Literally, same thing. Oh, no, I'm going to lose all this money. I'm looking at websites and they're saying, oh, this Venus conjunction is going to be bad for money. Who says? Lay a foundation. Do the work of the chart. The chart is about transforming things. And money is a very key area when Venus is in the neighborhood. Same thing I just said. If you're in a money partnership with somebody, use this energy to work on that. If you are not, maybe you're just a solopreneur, great time to plan next year. But especially the work of this full moon, aside from what we just talked about, is the work of transformation. So this is a great time to do all of the, some really serious stuff. And it's almost like a prep sheet, if you will, for the upcoming eclipse that will be on the 26th. So if you do your year-end review a little early, you will be catching it under a whole lot better energy, I promise, than champagne-induced New Year's Eve. This would be a lot better time to do that work, all right? So this is about wrapping up the old, planning the new. Set your intentions for 2020. Look at the areas where Saturn and Pluto might be knocking at the door of your life and asking for you to step up and change things. And change things is not just having regret, and it's not just like, oh, I blew it and I got caught. It's about making a list of what exactly am I going to do differently, and then be about the business of doing it differently. That's transformation. I love you under this full moon. Thank you for listening. That was a good Venus thing to say there. Seriously. And I wish you the very best full moon of the year right now.